We're more than Hazach. We have the power to prevail, to overcome, to resist every power of hell. We have the power to tread upon. We have the power to denounce. We have the authority to bind, to loose, as that has been nothing granted, permitted. It has been prescribed unto be at YisraYah. We are more than conquerors through the power of Almighty Yahweh, which is his revelation in Yeshua HaMashiach, that Torah of life, that even when the assault of hell rose up against the Torah, the message of Yah's truth, his shirt, his bosom, even it was cast lower than the depths of the earth. And even when Yahshua went down into the depths, the belly of the earth, there was no power that could abate, subdue, or to bring to naught the witness of Yah. Even in the midst of Hoshek, a mind, a conscience, a world that is full of darkness, whereby there is no correction or mishpatim, no judgment of the actions of that people, of that spear, whereby they defy all the corrections of Almighty Yah. And even when the assault of hell came against Yahshua HaMashiach, the living Torah of Yah, even in the midst of the darkness and the dungeons of hell, he rose up with all teshua, with all power, to grant unto the elect. The Bohir, I like that, the Bohir, the chosen ones, the choice ones, the supreme ones, that Yah, by his own predilection, not a democratic process. You did not need the Melechim to instruct. He said, that one is mine. These are mine. Although they may look despicable, and they shall be despised, they shall be hated of all men for my name's sake, yet Yah will not denounce Yisrayah. Even when we fall into the depths of great darkness and sin, if we can simply hear the quiet voice, it is directed toward you, Yisrayah, that we shall awaken, that we shall yachatz, that our mind shall be stirred, that our conscience shall come alive, that we shall begin to operate in the progressive power of Torah, not denying one word. We allow nothing to slip from us at all, Yisrayah. It is a time that Yisrayah must awaken. We must yakatz. We have been yoshim. We have been sleeping in a season whereby it is dark. We see the darkness that is polluting the world today. Every kind of constitution that defies Torah in the mind of the beast, it is being prescribed to the nations of the earth, to the forms of its media, its outlets, which are controlled by the powers of hell. And our minds are being contaminated with the falsisms of darkness, whereby we perceive that there is light in that darkness, but there is no light at all. We must yakatz. We must awaken Yisrayah out of our drunkard stoop, out of our intoxication of our flesh. We cannot move outside of the realm of that, because it commands, it drives, it drills us. It causes us to denounce Yah, but it doesn't cause us to denounce it. It is one of the most diabolical, infested things upon the face of the earth. when man gave Hoshotan that entrance to begin to process his DNA, within the bosom of man we have seen the ills and the wickedness of man. It is a mind that defies the Torah of Yah. You're not going over the Torah. For the Torah shall bring us all into judgment. It shall bring us all into condemnation. It will show us the vile nature of our own depraved, perverse mind, which is against the commands, the mitzvah of Yah. Zachar, remember Hashabbat? Shema, keep it. Chodesh. For there is no name like his name. We do not take his name in Shav in vain. For he that does so, he shall not be held guiltless. And that is the truth above all truths. Shema Chol Yisrael is Echad, is one. We must hear the one true word. And there is only one true word, the revelation, Yeshua HaMashiach. I want to, as I said last night, I want to teach today with the emphasis of our Zachin when they teach. I want to try with all of the essence of the teachings that I have learned from them, the protocol. And I believe this day I may be able to make it through, all right? But I want to warn us, Yisrael, that we must yachatz, we must awaken out of our drunkenness. And when one begins to yachatz, is one's conscience and mind is stirred. There's a life, there's a substance, there's a source that began to cause our minds to become powerful. That is the yachatz of Yah. That we become powerful. We have the power to pronounce. We have the strength, the knowledge to denounce that which is not of Yah. And we denounce it with all authority and power. We rise up. In the volume of the testimony of Yeshua, we rise up with great strength. We have the power to endure any battle of hell. We stand in the corrections, the muzah, the counsel, the correction, the reproof, the rebuke of Torah. Because that is what restrains us and brings us to the altar of Almighty Yah. That the power of Yeshua's testimony, his aid, may be established in our shards, our bosom, in our breath, in our loba, our minds, in our lib, our hearts. It must be established there because that is the only all-powerful testimony. We may have a testimony of diversity. He brought me out of this sin. He delivered me from this. But there is only one Ida. There is only one powerful testimony that says out of the midst of death and grave that you have brought him out. He was made alive by the Ruach of Yah. We don't have that one yet. And we will testify to that in the kingdom before the Melach that Yah has commanded to watch over and to preserve them that fear, or they have this yareh, this trepidation, that they have this great honor of reverence unto Almighty Yahweh. Only then can we testify of that testimony. So we as a nation, we as an ummah, a nation of a collection of people, we must awaken. We must yachatz. We must be aroused. We must stir up our pure mind, the mind that is set apart from the delights of this most damnable, twisted world. We must be free from the abominable activities and the vile nature of nations that prescribe laws to denounce the power of Yah, when they justify some of the most damnable and despicable acts, a damned man as a dog less than a dog, a damned woman less than a beast of the field. Yet they pass laws. I'm glad that there were a few nations on the continent of Africa, Mr. Mugabe and others, said, damn you, Mr. Barack Hussein Obama, damn your monies. We will not pass laws to justify one of the most vile natures against all creations of Yah. Two damned men cannot procreate. Two lesbian dogs out of hell cannot procreate. It takes an ish, a man, and an ishon in order to procreate. It cannot come any other way, Yisrael. It takes a living Torah in our bosom, the testimony of Yeshua, to create, to emphasize the power of Almighty Yah. I want, with all emphasis today, to teach us the importance of this hour to Yachatz, to awaken Yisrael. For this nation and the nations of the earth, we're not prepared for the coming. We're not prepared for the coming. Yeshua HaMashiach. And the only way that you're going to be awakened unto what? What shall we be awakened unto? Well, we will get to the depths of that as well. I want to begin. You are friends that have joined us in the book of Marcus Lucas. And the book of Luke. Hallelujah. Chapter 24. I want to begin at verse 25. I want to say this, Yisrael. There is no way that we as a nation of people, that we are going to be awakened or our conscience stirred, unless the power, the Kuach, the strength, the ability, the might of Yeshua HaMashiach is revealed in us. It cannot be. We have no power. We are not yachatz. We are not powerful. We don't have the strength to withstand. We cannot endure. The damned Christos are falling. The damnable, twisted gods are failing them. Call upon your gods. I will call upon the name of Almighty Yah, and we shall see who will deliver. Beginning in the book of Lucas, chapter 24. This is when Yeshua HaMashiach, when he appeared unto Cleophas, two of them on their way unto Emmaus, because the power of the testimony of Yeshua was not awakened in them. Yah has written that testimony. He has inscribed it only in the bosom of Yisrael, his elect. So when they hear the voice of Yeshua, it will cause the light. The light. So come on. It begins in this process, verse 25. Then Yeshua said to them, Cleophas, he said to them, he called them all ever, O fools. This is a foolish generation. And you must understand what an evil is. It is one that despises the wisdom, the chukmah of Yah. You cannot have chukmah. You cannot understand the experience of Yah without understanding the beauty of his mitzvah, his Torah. So he denounced them as an evil generation or people, all fools. He said that we are slow. We are impatient with Yah. We are slow of love
to obey, to say it is fulfilled,
to believe all that the Navi'im have spoken. If one declares himself a Nobi, and if he speaks not according to the Eduth, the Torah, and the prophets, it is because there is no power of the Or, the light, the witness of Yahshua HaMashiach in that man. He has no knowledge. He has no wisdom. He is one that despises wisdom. What our love is slow to embrace his imat. It's because there is an evil, a heart, a mind, and a conscience that despise the wisdom of Yah, but yet we gravitate to the folly and the foolishness of the world. We gravitate to those things that are not essential to our growth, YisraYah. He says unto them, did not HaMashiach have to suffer all these things? Did he not have to suffer the things he did? Sure he did. Are we not going to suffer? Many are the afflictions of the Sadiq. But Almighty Yah, he delivers, he Yoshach, he Nochan, he delivers them, he bestow unto them the power of light, the witness that Yahshua is real in them. We have a form of the power of Yah, but we deny the authority of that power which is in Yahshua HaMashiach. And so we're weak, and we're foolish, we're slow of heart, and we don't believe. We simply do not believe. We're a generation that's slow of love. We don't embrace Yah, but we are quick for those things that are wicked. We embrace that which is vile and corrupt. Did not Yahshua have to suffer these things? Was it not spoken by the prophets, the Navi'im, that he would suffer that? And he said, and to enter into his splendor and the gabol of the great honor of Almighty Yah. Are we not going to suffer these things to enter into the presence of Yah? We are going to have to suffer. We have not yachatz, we have not awakened that these circumstances make us powerful. It caused the power of light to shine. We are ignited by the things that we are afflicted by. Yet we are a nation of people that we murmur and we grumble just like Yisra'iyah. They came out of Mishraim. We cannot go that way, Yisra'iyah. Hallelujah. He has suffered that. We're going to suffer things to understand the beauty of Yah's splendor. We don't suffer things, we don't understand the might of his power. If there is no deliverance, then who are we relying upon? We're in circumstances where we have no power to deliver ourselves. Come on, this damnable sloth of hell, we cannot deliver our minds from it. It takes a witness that is more powerful than that. It takes a strength that is much more pronounced. For you are no match to the system of the world and the systems. You cannot. It will break you. It will subdue you. It will bring you down to the gates of hell. Do you all sure what he did? It says, and beginning the Bereshit, he began at Moshe. He did not say some of the Nobi. Of the Nobi, or the Nevi'im, he said, in all the prophets, he began to expound, he began to teach, he began to open up the wisdom and the knowledge of the testimonies that were spoken. He expounded to them in all HaKadosh, in all of the writing. Now listen, Yisra'iyah. There was no book called the Renewed or the Brit Milah, the Renewed Covenant. He began at Bereshit. And he brought them down through the chronicles, the course of time, to Melchiah.
He expounded in that book. And you children of hell that teach that the Torah is not sufficient to our growth and strength, you are a damn dog birthed out of the belly of a Jezebel. And I don't take that back. I don't give a damn who you are. He did not begin at Matitiah unto Gilead. No, he began at Moshe. And he brought them through the course of Melchiah. He expounded to them all the chatzvei, the chidvei ha-kadosh, the things concerning himself. For the volume of the book testify of Yeshua. For the volume of the book, he is the Torah of the words made flesh. He is the commands of Yah made, demonstrated to us in the office of flesh. Under the very corrupt thing that despise Yah, that resists, that constitute wickedness for righteousness, and denounce righteousness, and place it with that which is, or replace it with some of the most vile acts of darkness. He began in the Torah. Because the Navi'im, they taught out of the Torah. Because they had the light, they knew that HaMashiach would come. And to bring the revelation, the fullness of that wisdom unto Yisrael. He will bestow upon them the Ruach of Yah's mind, a living mind, that it feeds upon Torah. We feed upon every kind of damn thing that is damnation unto us. Every kind of lie, every kind of falsehood, every kind of pagan, every kind of ill. That's why we are ill as hell today. Our minds do not embrace Yah. Our minds do not pursue the power of Torah. Looking for alternatives. And they never bring a damn thing but death. They bring no shalom. He began the writings of the Torah. And he began to open them up. The fullness of that open book is in Yahshua HaMashiach. Only in him. The things that concern him. And they drew near to the village where they went. And he made as though that he would have gone farther. He continued in the process. It's one thing that Yah cannot go farther with us. Oh, I know how we see that in our intellectual receiving of that. But he made himself as though that he would go farther. Yah wants to take us farther than what we are. He wants to take us farther than the realm of our flesh. He wants to bring us into the spiritual realm, Yisrael. That his laws become the most pulsating power of our lives. That Yahshua will take us beyond our limitations. And so he went as though that he would go farther. He was going on. That's what he did. Well, he deceived them. No, he is not deceiving us. He wants to take us beyond the realm of our flesh. It was perceived as though that he would have gone farther. And then they constrained him. They actually compelled him, say, please, abide with us for a moment. They compelled him, saying, remain, stay, abide with us. For it is toward evening. He said, and the day of the Yom is far spent. It's over. So stay here. We're in the dark season, Yisrael. We have not allowed the day star of the light, the awe of Yahshua, the power of the testimony to rise in us. So we are children that are groping in the darkness. We are trying to find the way, and we cannot find the way. We are trying to utilize every kind of resource, but what Torah commands us. So the night is far spent. It is over with. And when the son of Siddiq shall rise, The power of Yah, he's going to arise with the Mishpatim, the judgment of condemnation. And to the nations of people that are foolish, they are evil. They are slow of heart to believe. You will know when one believes. Because when Christ, oh man, I concur. Faithful are your words. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are slow. Because we frankly do not give a damn. Oh, we all think that we are so spiritual. We all think that we spend sufficient time with the Most High. We frankly do not give a damn. Yahushua, he went in and stayed with them, verse 30. And it came to pass, as time progressed, it seemed as though that the time eclipsed so fast. I was saying to my Ach Shimri, the year in the Gregorian aspect, it has eclipsed us. It's gone. We get a little older and the time just fades away. And it came to pass as the yom was expense, the day, as light began to ebb, as he sat to eat with them, he took lachem, the bread, which is the life of Torah. He took bread and he brach, he blessed it, and he broke it, symbolizing his body. It would be marred. Azachin, Mahalaya, Azachin, Yarabaya spoke to us concerning his body, how it was broken, marred above all men. And he gave it to them. He has given us his body that has been brutalized for us. What is his body? It is the word. It is his Torah. That man has tried to break it. They have tried to obfuscate it. They have tried to make it irrelevant. They have tried to twist it. But it is established in the Her, the mountain of Almighty Yah. I don't know where his mountain is. Could not. I know that he is from Paran. Don't know how high it is. But I know that in a billion years, we could not scale to the 1 inch of the mountain of Yah. And the depth of his wisdom, all hell and all of his contingent cannot unearth where the wisdom of Yah is rooted, because they don't know the depths of his heart. And he has granted unto us the love of Yahushua to show us his depth, and we frankly do not give a damn. We say, damn is wisdom. He granted unto them the wisdom, the life, in the breath of Lachem. When they began to eat as Yisrael did, the manna, they knew not what it was. He was breaking unto them. He was breaking open the knowledge of Torah. He was revealing the tenets of the power of Torah. We must eat this Torah. It is the life source. These damn dogs are rejected. They have no life in them. They have this religious form, but there's nothing that they sin without conscience of their sin. For we know that sin is a transgression of Yah's Torah. That's what it is. When they began to eat, it says their ayin, their mental, their spiritual power to perceive, to understand. It says, and their eyes were pochah. Their eyes were open. The sensitivity, the knowledge was open. Open to what? What Moshe had written. What the prophets, the Nabi, had written. And it says, and they yada him. Until we awaken, we are not going to know him. We are drunk in our indecencies of our arrogance and our damn pride. This is a damn haughty generation. It is a vile generation. It is a damn religious generation. And it doesn't give a damn about the Most High. When they began to eat, their eyes were open. They were yachatz. They began to sense the power as it began to rise in them. Their minds became stirred in the pure messages of the prophets, what they had spoken. They went back to the Torah of Moshe and the revelation of that speaking of the living power of the Torah. But because we are fleshly, and because we're trying to determine that and interpret, deduct from Torah by our own twisted damn minds, we never relish in the power of Torah because we don't sense the spirit, the ruach, of the living power of Torah. And so we continue to abide in our sins, and we are dead in our sins, and we trespass, yeah. Because we denounce Torah, only then were their eyes open. You must eat. That's why the enemy got us eating every kind of damned perverted thing. You must eat the bread. You must eat Torah. In the morning, noonday, all day, you must eat Torah. And only then were their eyes open. And then they yada, they perceived, they knew, they began to brach, they began to bow. Then they knew him, and it says that he sarach, he vanished, or in essence, that he was loose from them. He had finished the commands of Almighty Yah. Then he sarach, he vanished out of their sight. And this is their response. And they said one to another, did not our labor, our hearts, our minds burn within us? Did not the fire, does not a burning fire illuminate light? And when we have the fire of Torah as Yerebeah, you will see a light in us. We are people that's dark. Our countenance is dark. Our conscience is dark. Because we feed on the dark matters continuously. We don't feed on the light of the Torah. We feed on the damn yesterdays and the yesteryears that did not produce a damn thing. Tomorrow, yesterday is finished. It's not going to produce anything but the wisdom of the experience that I encounter, that I will walk in the Torah or the light of Almighty Yahweh. And so we are a nation that gravitates back to even the unfinished works that we have not completed. And then we left all the other matters undone, and we are a ragged people wandering in a wilderness. A place that is barren, our minds are barren, because we will not eat. And our eyes are iron, our spiritual and mental faculties are opened. They're shut. The door has been jarred, and we cannot get out. That's why we constantly do the same things. That's why we don't give a damn. And we frankly don't give a damn about each other. Did not our love burn? There's nothing like a roaring fire in the midst of darkness. We need the burning fire. We need the burning fire of his Torah. And his Torah, his word, was like a fire, an ish, all shut up in my bones. What's shut up in our bones is some of the most vile perverseness than one could imagine. We don't know how to embrace the kindness of Yah, and like hell will we embrace the kindness of one another. I don't give a damn about what the circumstances may be. We don't even know how to embrace the gemuel, the gifts of one another. And if we don't know how to do that, you don't know how to embrace one of the most powerful gifts that have been given.
That's the gift of Yahshua. We are damn twisted people. And I don't give a damn who you are, who you may be. I will not back down. We must be awakened. And the only way we're going to be awake, we must be gotten to eat. Feed me as they eat, Santa, until I want no more. We're eating, but it's not Torah. We're eating, but we don't and do not have the Rapha, the healing. He is not Yah Rapha. He is not our healer. Did not the revelation and the wisdom of this Torah burn within us while he talked with us by the way? He talked with them by the way. What is Derecha, or the way? It is called Torah. That is what it was called by the old Chorushim. They will call it the way. And so he brought them along the way. That is what light does. It brings us along the way. And the way is the path of the Torah. Did not our hearts burn? Did not the fire ignite in us when he brought us along the way? The wisdom, the understanding, the revelation of Torah. Did not our hearts become excited? There's only ichas derech, one way. Derech ichat, only one way. Only one way into the melchut, the kingdom, whereby one may enjoy the riches of the knowledge of Torah. There's only one way. It's not through your damn Jesus Christ. It's not through your damn gods. I'm appalled by these most damnable, twisted hypocrites. They call themselves the sons of Abraham, Hebrews. They call themselves YisraYah. Yet they all take upon an Aramaic, a Hebraic name. Every heathen nation, their deity and their God, they call them the language, the Loshon, the Fef, the speech of their mouths. They call them by the name of their language. Those that were from Taiwan, when they come to America, they do not translate or transliterate the name of their God to an English God. They call him a Taiwanese name. Those that are in China, those of India, their Brahma, their gods, 320 million, they call them, those that have knowledge of that God, they call them by the language or the name that the God was created in and made known to them. And yet those that say they're Hebrews, they have their damn Germanic Anglo-Saxon name to their damn Jesus, their damn Christ. I am not afraid to say that. And yet their names are Yakahanan, their wife's name Elisheba, and all of that. And yet they call upon some of the most hideous, damnable pagan names. You're going to don your wickedness, and I'm here. You know where to find me. I'm here. I want to debate with them. I do. I'm not afraid. 20 of them. You may lose. I don't lose. They may scar me, but that's all right. I don't want to remove myself from this path. Awaken Yisrael. Hallelujah. Yeah. Continuing on in this process, in verse 44. I want to open your eyes to one of the most profound awakenings, the Yachatz, the awakening of Yah, how that the mind was illuminated, the mind was stirred. It is only through Yahshua. You will not understand the light of Yah unless you understand the revelation of Yahshua. What is that? I want to break it down in the simplicity of its form. It is that, as the old ones would say, he must be real. The reality of what he has wrought, done, and worked for us, it must be the very strength of our hearts that we resort to that in the midst of every kind
of circumstance and trial. We don't resort to the testimony. We resort to our emotions and our own actions to resolve. We don't resort to prayer anymore. We don't resort. We're trying to find out and seek out by our own predilection. But we don't seek the face of Yah no more. And that's the truth. And those that represented YisraYah, those is Shalishuam, that represent the very power of YisraYah, even their minds were blinded as they all walked away. You have never walked away from Yahshua? Sure, we walk away every Shabbat. We hear the Torah spoke. We walk away every Chatve Imat. We walk away from that. We turn our attention away from that truth. And we began to pursue other orders and other events and other activities that will not strengthen that in our bosom. And we find ourselves weak. We find ourselves sleeping. We're dead. There's no life of His Torah in our bosom. We find ourselves drunken because our sins have overtaken us. We find ourselves immersed in every kind of vile practice there is because we have not been awakened. Our minds have not been stirred up, YisraYah. It has not. Our minds have not been aroused. Our hearts do not pulsate with this powerful testimony. Lucas 24, verse 44. As he says unto his Shalishim, and he said to them, he said, these are the words of the Dabarim, the words which I spoke to you while I was yet with you. You've already heard. That's why we must Shemach Ya Yisrayah. We must hear. Our ears, our eyes must be open with a faithful pursuit to obey and to be led by that. We may perceive what one is saying, but we do not shemach. He said, these are the dabarim that was spoken unto you, which I spoke unto you while I was yet with you. He says that all things must be galah. They must be fulfilled. They must be completed. Everything must be completed. That these things must be kala. They must be accomplished according to what is already written, which were written in the Torah of Moshe. That's why he began at Moshe. He said, all things, the Kalah is saying that the power of Torah, it must have its finished work in this fleshly nature. It must overcome, it must render it powerless. It must subdue it, YisraYah. It must. All things must be Kalah. They must be finished. All things according to the Torah must be accomplished in our flesh. And everything, every writing, every statute must be kala in our flesh. There's not one statute that's done away with. There is not one writ of the Torah that is done away with. It was fulfilled. Or the power of that was revealed in a living way in Yahshua HaMashiach. And when that testimony is real in us, we carry the light of the Torah. We fulfill all things. It is what asah fashion our minds. It is what makes us complete, YisraYah. These damn lying dogs, your children of hell to teach the lies you're teaching. And in hell, you're going to lift up your eyes. And that's a fact. You're raised up to now be the strong man. We need strong men. We need strong men. A strong man doesn't has to express his strength. It is his presence that expressed that. It says that all things must be kala, fulfilled which were written in the Torah of Moshe, not only in the Torah of Moshe, but in the Nevi'im, or the Navi'im, or the Nabi, the prophets. He says, and even in the Tehillim, or the Tehillim, in the Psalms, he says concerning me, all that was written. It was Hattab. And yet man deducted it by a letter of the writing, but he had no power of the Ruach. It is the letter that kills. It is the letter that kills our determination, our will, our purpose. But it is the Ruach of that living Torah, or the truth of the Torah, that makes us alive. It gives us the Chai. We become a living, robust being. It is the power of that testimony makes us, or give us the strength, because Torah lives, because Yeshua lives. We can live and face tomorrow. Why? Because as the song says, it is so high, there's no power of hell that can scale the walls of the Torah and destroy the might of Yeshua. The gap and the breadth of his mind, it is so broad, because it is the mind that created all things. It is the mind of Yeshua that created all things. His mind is a living Torah. His mind is the concept of Yah. His mind is Yah. His mind is the authority of Yah. His mind is the will of Yah. That's why we must allow the mind of Yeshua HaMashiach to be in us. The same mind. It must be permitted to operate in us. YisraYah. And after he expounded, you're not going to understand the depths until you understand the writings from Bereshit to Giliana. It says, and then he opened their minds, their, you know, their understanding, that they may be revelation, that they may understand Kadosh, that they may understand scripture. We must awaken that we can discern what is of Yah. And the only way that our spiritual minds will be open, it is through the revelation of Torah. Then, beginning at Moshe, he began to read and open up the Torah. And when they heard that, all of the writings that were fulfilled in that body, and what has been written from Moshe unto Giliana, it must be fulfilled in us. Don't you know there's a great expectation of us? There's a greater beauty to us that even that those before us had. And the Lord shall be first. We are so full of folly and so ignorant. We will not even reprove ourselves of our ignorance. And the first shall be last. And the last shall be first. There's a greater beauty of Torah that you are in the midst of this great trial that he wants to bring forth to the world, that they will see and say, who is like unto this mighty one? Damn every God, the Christo, the Christ, the Jesus, because all of your damn Jesuses are different. You got the black one, you got the white one, you got the brown one, you got the Mexican, you got the Chinese Jesus, and they're all full of lies. Damn them all. You got a Pentecostal Jesus, you got the Baptist Jesus, you got the Methodist Jesus, you got the Hebrew Jesus, you got the Edomite Jesus. They're all full of lies. Yeah. Only Yah, the mighty one of Yisrael. Why do you talk like that, man? Because I like fighting. I like to fight. I'm set to defend the power of his truth. I like to fight. I want to fight. That's why I say it like that. I want the assaults and the insults. Hallelujah. Only then did he open up their eyes to the understanding of the Torah of Yah, that they might understand Chesvei HaKadosh, that they may understand Torah. It's only when Yahshua becomes the essence of your life. He is not the essence of our lives. Hell Walmart plays a greater part of our lives than Yahshua. Our own damn greed plays a greater part of our life than Yahshua. Our vile nature
what, on day before yesterday they had their Thanksgiving, a day that is predicated upon the butchering and killing, the destruction. They ate their damn chicken and chitlins and hog heads and their ham, their country hams. They ate their clam chowder. It's wickedness. It's wickedness. It's not a day of Todah filled with drunkenness. Hell, they're arresting them because they're trying to get ready for their damn Xmas, their Christ day. They're full of the damn hypocrisy. They're fools. They're ignorant. Are we participating in the damn wicked activities? Nay, will I? Damn your Thanksgiving. And you damn liars that say that it's all right to celebrate, that you're a damn liar. Don't send me your damn wicked cards. I don't give a damn who you are. Don't send me no happy Thanksgiving or that mess. I have one that says that he is the Torah teacher to send me happy Thanksgiving. And the rage of Yah's wrath burned in me. I didn't respond to the cowardly little beast. If he listened, he knows who he is. You better repent, man. Hallelujah. I'd rather have the friendship of Yahshua than the friendship of this worldly conscience, this worldly mind. I'd rather have that. He will reprove me. He will rebuke me. He will chasten me. He will correct me. I want to be corrected. Me left to myself, I make a fool of myself. But I'm glad he doesn't leave me alone. I'm glad he brings me into the way, that he may open up the understanding of Torah unto me, that my bosom may be open to receive the wisdom of his Torah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That we may, Yisrael, we must understand. We may, Kala, that our understanding, we may understand the finished work that was in Yahshua. That word is very powerful, the word Kala, that Yahshua says that that all things must be fulfilled. It is Kala. I want to show you an expression in the beginning, how that word is expressed, or its power. Turn quickly to Bereshit. I want to give you a reference of this word, Kala. To complete, it must be finished. It must be done in the precise order. It must be done through the regiment of one that has power to instruct in the regiment. Bereshit chapter 2, verse 1, I'm going to begin reading. Two verses here. And this is the same word, Kala, to finish, to complete, to do it thoroughly, that there are no questions asked. It says here in Bereshit, Genesis chapter 2, verse 1, and I'm reading this to open up our understanding of the power of Yah's expression. It says, so the Shemayim, the Hashemayim, and the Olam, the earth, it was Kala. Can that be altered? You cannot alter that. So the earth and the heavens were finished. No power against the very creation of Yah, its raging, can destroy that. And so when the heavens and the earth were Kala, they were finished, and all of their hosts, all of the hosts. You understand that Yahshua says that even what is written, beginning in the Bereshit unto Melchiah, I have finished that. I have Kala. And he gives us a precise reference of that. We're lazy as hell. We don't search out the beauty of Yah. We don't unravel the layers. But I'm one that unravel the layers. I want to know, why did you say that, Yahshua? What is the value of that? Verse 2. And on the seventh day, on the Shabbat, Yom, Yah, he Kala, he Kala, he ended his work which he had made, and he Shabbat, the seventh day, from all his work which he had asa, which he had fashioned. The word Kala, he completed all things. He completed all things. You're sure again, he said, for it is written in the Torah, everything that is written, that all things must be fulfilled. What things? Which were written in the Torah of Moshe, and in the prophets, the Nevi'im,
And also in the Psalms Tehillim of Dawid, and also all things concerning me. He said, I had to kala. I had to show you the end result. And now you can rest assured, did not ya rest? When we and you are sure of the power of that testimony, we can rest. We're laboring all the time. Our minds are running faster than a Boeing 747. I was reading the other day that it could be fictitious, but the United Snakes, the demonic power of this nation, that they have the military power, the technology to fire a missile from anywhere in the United States, and within 1 hour, it will reach its destiny, even in Russia, even in Iran. They have that kind of power. You know why they have that? Because it is the prince of the powers of the air. It is the workers of darkness, and this nation, it is the cauldron of every kind of darkness. The leaders, the minds are created by the wicked spiritual rulers that rules every aspect of our lives. They rule our children in their schools. They rule your conscience in their material. They create your mindset according to their delight. That they manipulate, they use us, they rob us, they rape us like a two-rata slot in the brothel house of hell. We are such a damn ignorant generation. We don't know how to honor the strength of Yah. We don't give a damn about those that could teach us and show us the power, the beauty of the strength of Hamashiach. We need men. I looked at an article this morning. I didn't even read it. That the nature of this bastard slip. You must understand that a bastard is one that has no identity to its birthright. Our identity starts with the avats. Araim is the seed bearer. Our beginning starts with Adon, and Adon beginning starts with the Most High. He is a man of war. And I looked at the article as I read the headlines. I didn't want to read it because I know how my heart is. Nearly 1 million women in the land of Iraq are left widows because their husbands have been butchered by the bastard slip, the mind of this nation. And the nations like Britain and France and Portugal and Greece, Italy, and they're all catching hell, are they not? Yah is not mocked. Be not deceived, Yah is not mocked. For whatsoever nation soweth, a people, a land, that shall they also reap. I'm telling you, America, your sons are going to die. Your sons are dying today in the streets of drug-induced minds. Your daughters are dying. They have no conscience today at all. Death, the mavet of Yah. They don't give a damn about the standards of Yah. An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. You have robbed them of their eyes. And your sons and daughters' eyes have been robbed too. Come out of her, Yisrayah. Don't touch this dirty Jezebel, this Isabel. Don't allow her to train your mind. We must, your cats, we must awaken. We must be aroused out of our sleep as the five wise and even the foolish. But only the wise had the oil. Only the wise had the substance. We must be aroused in the midst of this darkness. Where damn faggot dogs are parading around and these butch bull dagger sluts where these damn faggot men that they call themselves leaders of the people are raping the daughters of children, where your educators are sleeping with your 5, 6, 8, 10-year-old sons and your daughter, you trust your children to these damn serpents of hell. You're a damn Jezebel woman. You're a vile thing of a man. You jackass of a man. You're not even a man.
Cannot go around.
Cannot go around, cannot go around.
Torah of Yah, cannot go around. Awaken, your hearts, for the day of Yah is near. His kala is finished. All that I need is in Yahshua. He satisfies joy, he supplies. Life would be worthless without him. All things in Yahshua I find everything we need. We're not complete outside of him. Without the testimony, our eyes are shut. We don't perceive. We have no wisdom of revelation of what the events are beginning to progressively eclipse before us, what they mean and what shall be our end. As well, awaken Yisrael, let us your hearts, not your sheen, not sleep, but let us your hearts, let us be aroused, let us rise up, let us stand up for the Sadiq of Yah, the power to endure, and let us be established in the Torah of Almighty Yahweh, of the power of Yahshua HaMashiach.
It is one thing that Yahshua came to do. He did not come to denounce. He came to Yahatz, to open our eyes to the power of Torah. It was one thing when Adram and Chava, when they defied the commands of Yah, that their eyes were shut. We can see the result of that.
With Kayan and Aben, we can see the result. It produced death. He came to Mala, he came to open up and fulfill the power of Torah that our spiritual eyes may be opened, that we will know it is in the power of that covenant whereby we as a nation, we rise up, whereby we as an ummah, a community of Yisrael, we stand, we endure against all powers of hell that rages against us. Listen to this in Matithiyah. Yahshua came to confirm the Torah of Yah. In essence, to male, to mala, to accomplish, to make sure that the finish, every jolt, every tirola, that everything precisely by the commands of Yah, they were fulfilled. He made sure that it would satisfy the heart of Yisrael. He came to satisfy the heart of Yah. Did he not? Did he not? Did not Yah say, this is my well-beloved son in whom I am well pleased? And the only way you can be well pleased is by his wisdom. That's why an avot tries to teach his son. If he loves his son, he tries to teach him his wisdom. Matithiyot 5 and 17, he says, I don't want you to think not that I've come to shamay, to destroy, to annihilate, to devastate the Torah or the prophets because they have written to me. The Torah speaks of Yahshua. Why would he destroy that? You understand that why these damn lying dogs tell you, well, the Torah, we don't need that. You are stupid. You're not even stupid. You're not even a fool, man. He said, don't even perceive one iota. Don't even allow your mind to be that vile to think that I've come to destroy, to shamah, to shamim, to destroy, to devastate, to annihilate the Torah of Yah. He saw all the prophets, the Nevi'im. He said, I came not
to destroy, but to male. I came to fulfill. I came to satisfy every aspect of the Torah. That's what we are to do. We must be awakened unto that. The enemy is keeping us in drunkenness by the delusion of our flesh. That's why, YisraYah, there is so much advertising today. You can't even turn around. Everything advertises. Everything. Everywhere you look is some form of alluring and drawing one's passion away from that thing of simplicity that causes them to be aroused with greater joy and excitement. And everything you see, everything today is some kind of altering type of psyche effect on our minds, especially Yisrael, because the enemy is trying to find the zira. He's trying to find the seed. He doesn't give a damn no more about America. Damn white America. Damn Jewish America. Damn Islam America. Damn white Germany. Damn black Africa is what the enemy of hell says. You seek the remnant of the zero. You seek the ball here. He doesn't give a damn about polluting their minds. You actually think that what we call the powerful rich white Americans care about the damn poor white Americans? You are a damn flat out fool. No more than the damn rich ones that call themselves black or Hebrews don't give a damn about the poor ones. It's a damn jackass, stupid generation. Only a white man is offended by that, or a black man. Damn your whiteness and your blackness too. You need to listen to the message I preach on the white mind. I'm going to teach more on that. They don't give a damn. The powers that be don't give a damn about your dirty, stinking flesh. It stinks. It's rotten. It's vile. And you defend white America? Damn white America. Damn white Russia. You defend black America? Damn black America. I defend Yeshua. I defend that testimony. I defend Yeshua. Damn the robbers' clan. I don't defend that. I defend the house of Yisrael. Yeah. Hallelujah. You see why I don't make many friends. I had someone to post a message on one of our videos that said, every word out of that man's mouth, he's cursing. Well, I'm using what's written in the book. And because they receive not the Ahad, the love of Torah, I will send them strong delusions that they all might be damned. All right. Did Yah say that? Okay. If he said it, damn America. It's going to be damned. Mr. Jeremiah Wright, he was not wrong in his assessment. The rich, greedy bastards out of hell that made us all slaves. That's a fact. Yeshua said, think not that I've come to Shomim to destroy Torah or the Nabi, the Nevi'im. I came not to destroy, but to male. I came to satisfy the elements of Torah. I came, Matityah 5:17, I came to make sure that every aspect was carried out in the precise order that Yah commanded, so that that precise order will operate in the bosom of Yisrael. That the Torah will care us or take us or lead us by the preciseness of the mind of Almighty Yah. The Torah is Yah's mind. That's why the enemy fight against us so much. What's enemy? Our flesh. For the carnal mind is enmity against the Torah of Yah. It is not subject to the Torah, neither indeed can be. We must awaken. We must yachat Yisrael. Our minds must awaken. Our hearts must awaken. Hallelujah. We must, Yah must, just like Dawid. I want to read this verse of Dawid as he cried in the agony unto Almighty Yah. He wanted him to rescue his being, his nefesh, from the power of his enemy's destruction. And he cries here in Tehillim quickly. He says, Yah Tehillim 35 and verse 23. He wants Yah to yachatz, to oar, to stir. Psalms 35 verse 23 is the first word in your writing, stir. He says, or Yah, or yachatz. He said, awaken me, cause my bosom to be excited and incited. Awaken your hearts. He says, stir up yourself, Yah. He's commanding Yah to rise, to awaken unto my cause. He says, and I want you to awake. He said, I want you to quote Yah, come alive, awaken judgment, mishpat. Even to my cause. He says, Yah, you're my Abba and my sovereigns. Then he asks Yah to Shafat, judge me, O Yah, my Abba, according to your Sadiq, according to your righteousness. Yahshua is the awakening power of Yah in the flesh of man. That testimony awakens us. It causes y'all to be awakened. And it begins with his mishpat that he judges us. This is a nation of people, we don't want the judgment of Yah. We don't want our hearts to be indicted of our criminal activities that we perform. I don't give a damn how right you think you are. Listen, Yisrael, yeah, it's right to do tov to our neighbors all the time. It is not by your damn perception whether one is tough. Even the wicked will be tough to you. And they will do right by you. What a man does right by you, it reciprocates. You do right by them. I don't give a damn what has risen. It is the sovereignty. It is the righteous nature of one that turns away your damn wrath. That's why he said, judge me. Awaken unto your mishpat. Judge me, Yah. Arise, Yah. Awaken up because my enemies are assaulting me. They're driving me. I want you to awaken, Yah. That should be our prayer. Awaken, Yah. Awaken, Yah. Your cats. Stir up yourself, Yah. Or awaken yourself. And I want you to begin with your Sadiq judgment. No man can do tough unless it's the leading of Yah. You can't even do tough unto each other. You cannot. As much as we have opportunity to do evil unto, as much as we as Yisrael, we have opportunity, it tells us to do what? Talk to me, to some men, to all men. Then it said, especially they of Yisrael. You don't even insult one when they do tough to you. It's a damn wickedness. I don't give a damn about your childish nature, your immaturity. Cannot go around. Cannot go around. I stand for truth. I don't stand for any wicked recourse or actions. I stand for truth. Hallelujah. That's why we as wise, we have to be wise. I don't care if your husband, wives have to be wise to hear the matter. Then you ponder it in the matter of Yahshua. You don't act rationally or irrationally. You act in the rational jurisprudence of the judgment of Yah. You judge your mind, your intent, your motive, your purpose. What has stirred you, you judge that first. Then you say to you, ach, come on, let's come give me a kiss. Hallelujah. I like this man, yeah, I like him. I really do. I love me. Ma'ima, I love me very much. I love me. If I can love me, I can love you. All right. Hallelujah. He says, judge me, O Yah, my Abba, according to your Sadiq. He said, don't let them rejoice over me. Don't let the wicked. Awaken, Yah. Awaken. I want you to rise up out of your slumber. I want you to awe. I want to excite you by my prayer. You see what things that I'm being entrapped by, my enemies around me. So we must cry out to Yah that the power of his testimony is awakening us. What is awakening us in the midst of the onslaught or the tremendous pursuit of our enemy? We began to awaken experience and thoughts. We began to talk to ourselves, and it does us no good at all. We find ourselves weak. We find our power diminishing. We find ourselves falling into all kinds of seductive manners and ways that are not productive in our lives. What we must say, awaken, Yah. We want you to and begin at the gate of judgment. We want to begin to enter into the gate of your mishpat. And now we all going to stand before the judgment seat of Almighty Yah. We must awaken unto that Yisrael. You can think you're getting by. You can act self-righteous all you want to. It doesn't mean a damn thing to Yah. You can think you're right. There is no right unless it's according to Torah. We are a people that are disposed of reacting according to our emotions. We must react according to what is right. You love your neighbor as you love yourself. You will never see an evil intent of your neighbor, to do you ill. But because you don't give a damn about you, you don't understand the love of anyone else. That's a damn wickedness, woman. He said, begun, awaken unto your judgment. That's where we need Yah to start. Awaken. Judge me. Correct me, Yah. Correct me. Correct me, Musa, counsel me, chastise me, correct me in what your mishpatim, your judgment, and not in his wrath, his indignation, unless you bring me to nothing. So awaken unto what is sadiq, awaken unto righteousness. We must yachatz unto what is right. And we know what is right. His Torah. His Sadiq is an everlasting Sadiq. And his Torah is Imad. His mitzvah, his commandments are Sadiq. Sure they are, Yisrael. We must awaken unto that. Hallelujah. What? As I said in the beginning, I want to show us what we must awaken unto. The power, the substance, and the strength. Sha'ul gives us a profound clarity, a declaration in the book of Ephesus or Ephesians chapter 2. Chapter 5, verse 14. Turn there first and then hold 2 and 1. But Ephesians chapter 5, verse 14. We as a nation of people, as the ummah, the nation, the community of Yah, we must awaken. It says, therefore, Yah says, he want us to awaken or kutz, and that is too abruptly. He want us to kutz, to awaken out of our sleep, our yashind. He says, I want you to arise, listen now, from the dead. And we know where we were. Hold that right there. He tells us to rise from the dead, doesn't he? He tells us to rise, to awaken, to stir ourselves from the dead. Now turn to Ephesians 2 and 1. This is the dead. This is the nature of death. And you, Yisrael, has Yah made alive or quickened who were dead in trespasses and sin. What is sin? Sin is the trespass or the trespassing of the Torah. When you trespass the Torah, then you are in sin. So he tells us to arise from the dead. For what reason? That Yeshua HaMashiach may give you light or. Then he opened up their understanding to what was written in the Chitve HaKadosh. I want to show you what's written in this book, Yisrael. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Proverbs, Mishli. What do we got here? It says, then when we arise out of our sin, when there is no desire and urging to practice that which is illegal against the Torah, then we do not have this dark cloud over us. We have arisen. We have come alive. There is no desire to practice that which defends or offends Yah. We must arise out of that. And what is the light that Yahshua shall give us light? He shall no fun to give is no fun. He shall bestow, permit. He shall cause it to arise. He shall cause the power and the strength of that to be visible unto us. Only Yahshua can give us light. That's why we need the testimony. Arise out of our sin that Yahshua will give us light. He will give us awe. He will give us the quickening. He will cause us to rise, that the light, the fire of Yah may burn in the bosom of Yisrael, the testimony of rejoicing and delight, of the abundance of His power, His riches, that is bestowed upon a people that's not even worthy of that, Yisrael. What light shall He give us? I began here in the book of Mishlei, Proverbs, chapter 3. Chapter 6, verse 23. What is the light? Proverbs, the wisdom of Shlomo, the wisdom of Yah's counsel, teach here in Mishlei 6:23. He says, for the mitzvah, the commandments of Yah, these are the mitzvah. It is a near, it is a lamp. And what does a lamp do? A lamp does what? It gives us light. For it is a near, and the Torah is light. Does it say that? And the Torah is light. It says the law is light. The Torah is light. Again, Shaul says, arise from the dead, and Mashiach shall give you light. And your Torah is light. And to checha, reproof, the rebuke of Torah's correction, of Musa instruction, are the way. And as they walked in the way, when they thought or he gave them perception that he would go farther, as they were walking in the way, he opened up their understanding. You think that when Yah says something, the words are not precise? They are not of great value, magnitude, and strength. You think not? We're ignorant people. We don't like to call ourselves ignorant, but we will call someone else ignorant. We're dumb. We're ignorant. We're foolish. We're wicked. We're an unlearned generation. We think someone else is unlearned. We will identify ourselves that way. That is the way of high, of life, cause us to become living, that we bear forth the substance of life. And the only way you're going to have life is through the light. And the only way the light is going to shine is through the power of the testimony of Yahshua HaMashiach. And without that testimony, we have no light at all. We must arise from our dead, wicked ways. And allow the testimony of Yahshua to bring light into our bosom. And the wisdom of that testimony teach us the principles and the power of Torah. Yahshua is the lamp. He is the one that draws us near unto Yah. He is the near of Yah. He is the lamp. He is the power of the mitzvah of Yah. His bosom is the mitzvah. He is the power of mitzvah. He is the law. He is the Torah. He is the Lord. Five foolish and five wise. And the rose all had lamps, did they not? But the five wise filled theirs with the testimony of the witness of Yahshua, and they had light. In this damn dark age, without this testimony, you have no light. You're groping about and stumbling and you're falling into every kind of religious practice and seductive power of hell to draw you away from the simplicity of the Torah of Yah. You're relying upon emotions and every kind of superficial feelings that do not produce one damn thing at all. It produced death. It produced sin. It produced rejection of Almighty Yah. He must bring us to the light. His Torah is light. His Torah. We must awaken to the light. Awaken ye drunkard, as your LD cries, for the day of Yah is at hand. We're drunk with the cares of this life and the worldly things. We're drunken by that. We must awaken. YisraYah. His Torah is, or it is light. It is the light of instruction. Did not Joshua instruct them in the ways of the Moshe's Torah? Did he not instruct them in the prophets? Did he not instruct them in the heart of David, the apple of Yah's eye? Come on, YisraYah. All the prophets. Shlomo is of the bosom of David. He's the strength of David's wisdom. He is the strength of Dawid's wisdom. It was only because he had blood on his hand that he could not build the house. He was the only one that had YisraYah as Ichatz. And Shlomo, because he did not walk in the instructions of that wisdom, he caused the house to be divided. And that's why we as YisraYah, we are divided today. Why halt ye between two opinions? You understand what the word opinion is? It's a judgment. There's only one Mishpatim, or only one Mishpat, the judgment of Yah, that only matters. Hallelujah. We allow the Torah to judge us. And when the Torah judges us, we won't halt. We won't walk. We won't leap over to that because we know it's wrong. We'll walk the straight and the narrow, YisraYah. I said to you all, it will be a simple message today. Simple, so plain. Can I move a little farther? I want to finish this today. Hallelujah. 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 There's only one way, YisraYah, that we're going to understand and know that one that is the true messenger, that he is walking in the light of the revelation of Yahshua HaMashiach. And there's a true litmus test. And it's found here in Yeshaya Isaiah chapter 8 and verse 20. I quote this all the time, but I want to read it to you. Yeshaya Isaiah 8:20. It says, to the Torah and to the testimony, Te'udah, the testimony, and this Te'udah is the confirmation of what the prophet said. To the Te'udah, if they speak not according to this word, it is because there is no light in them. If they speak not according to the Torah, there is no light in the man. If they speak not according to the Torah and the Te'udah, or the confirmation of the prophets, did not the prophets confirm the Torah? It's because there is no testimony of Yahshua HaMashiach in them at all, YisraYah. They are deceivers, they are ambassadors of hell. They have gone forth in the spirit of deceit, and they're going to bring you down because your mind is silly. You're laid with sin. You're in tune with sin. You're bogged down with sin. So they creep into your damnless silly house, and they lead you astray by your own damn silliness and your fallenness, because you think you know, and you really don't know one damn thing at all. If they testify or they speak not according to the writings of Moshe, if they speak not according to the confirmation of the prophets of Moshe, it's because there's no power of the testimony of Yahshua in them. We must awaken. We must Yakatz YisraYah. We must awaken unto the subtleties of hell, because Hoshatan was the most subtle one of the garden. No one, there was no other beast like him. We must awaken. So if I don't speak according to that, then you know there is no witness of Yahshua HaMashiach in me. I will give us confirmation in all of this when I finish to make our hearts fat. Hallelujah. I want to cut us all open today. That'll make sure I sew us up. But I want to put some healing balm in there before I sew you up. Hallelujah. Is that all right? Sure it's all right. Hallelujah. 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 We as this nation
YHWH speaks in chapter 51, Isaiah. He speaks of the light upon the people of Almighty YAH. Isaiah 51, verse 4. YAH says, I want you to shemach, listen to me, my people. He says, and I want you to give ozin, I want you to perceive what I am saying to me. And he calls us, oh my nation, we are the light. It's where the light shines forth. Out of YisraYah. Again, he says in YHWH, we as the people of YAH, the light should shine forth out of us. YHWH 51 verse 4, listen to me, my people, this is YAH. He says, I want you to shemach, hear me. He says, I want you to give ozein. I want you to perceive by the ear of your mental ability and spiritual. I want you to give not ozein, but ozein. I want you to give ear to me. He says, oh, my nation, my ummah, my people, my community. For a Torah perceived from me, and I will make my judgment, my mishpat. Does it say judgment? He says, it's going to raga, rest, to stir you up. Now, I put that word here in my text, raga. It means this. I want you to understand this. It means to stir up, to disturb, to yachatz YHWH. And yachatz is to be stirred up. Stir up our pure mind by way of remembrance of what? Torah. It is to disturb, to toss violently and suddenly. It is the Torah that tosses us violently and suddenly. He says again, I will make my mishpat, my judgment, to raga, to rest. For what? For a what? For a what? For a light of what? Of the people. Who was he talking to? YHWH. That's why YHWH said, think not I've come to destroy the world, to condemn it. YHWH came because in the midst of the world, there's a house there that YAH is going to save. He didn't have to destroy because it was already condemned. The world is condemned. This world of corruption is already condemned. You can try to justify, but it's already condemned. A God, he says, listen to me, my people. He's talking to his people. He said, and give ear to me, O my nation, for a Torah shall proceed from me. YHWH is the Torah. Did not he come from the Abba? For he proceeded from his father. He said, a Torah shall come from me, and I will make my judgment to rest where? I will make my judgment to rest for a light of the people. We are the people of YAH, and the light of YAH rests upon us. It is the Torah for the nations of the earth. It is the witness of YHWH HaMashiach. We must awaken to that. Our activities are as wicked as the world. We don't give a damn about each other. We care more for the gods than we do YHWH. We have no thought and consideration of YHWH. And it's wrong. I will make my Torah to rest, to stir up, to agitate, to jar us violently, and that's what he's trying to do today, violently jar us, to move us in the position that we may hear, that we may shemach what YAH commands unto his people. He shall make it to raga, to rest, to stir up, to disturb. See, this disturbs us, and it should disturb us, to disturb, to toss us violently and suddenly. We hear the things and violently it tosses us. It wretches us between our flesh and our damned juvenile emotions. Grow up. Get over your little juvenile damned emotions and feelings and grow up. Be a man, be a woman. That's what we do, hell. You think I'm going to let what happened yesterday, the day before, offset me today? You're silly as hell. I will not allow that. I don't relish in things like that. Okay, that's okay. You did that. That's all right by me. It's over with. Okay, move on. Let's go. Let's move on to the next plateau, because this here is not going to cause me to be awakened and to move in the knowledge of the light of Torah of Almighty Yah. I hope this is making sense. You are friends that have joined us. We're going to finish this today, all right? Just bear with me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm trying to do my best to teach and to do it in a way of a more, but I get a little excited at times. So you all have to bear with me. I'm not going to apologize because I get a little excited. I'm not trying to do anything to make amends. I'm trying to stir us up as your commands here. We as a people, we should stir up. We should, as his judgment rests upon us, as a light of the people. That's the only light that we have. His mishpat, and we hate that. We're a nation that is so damn self-righteous. We think our actions are right. They're not right. Every concept, every deed we do should be, it should be judged by Torah. And then if your sister, your brother have sinned or offended you, you go on to them. Do not reject them. That's not the way of God. We must be awakened. This is a tool of hell to draw Yisrael away. That we will be gone to war and fight. From whence come all this fighting and warring among Yisrael? Yeah. Is it not because of our own corruption, your own wickedness? Yes. You have not allowed the light of Torah to judge you. Yes. We become so damn self-righteous, we can't even see what is right. We can't see anything that's done from a pure nature of Yisrael. Come on, something is wrong. That's why there are many that despise me. I was talking to one yesterday, people that don't even know me, one in Buffalo, New York, telling me of one, talking to someone, and talking against or about me, and they don't even know me. They don't like the way I talk. They don't like what I convey. They don't like my ruach. They don't like me exposing their damn wickedness. That's what they don't like. They find out what kind of shallow of a man you really are and the woman you think you really are. And what kind of false damn love you think you have. We don't want that. We love being false, full of damn pretense. We don't know what it is to be real. Because we're not real with ourselves. When you're real with yourself, you will repudiate you and show you. Listen, when you awaken in the morning, you don't awaken me. You awaken you, don't you? I awaken me. When I'm awakened unto me. I'm awakened unto my ways. I am the one that is the life that God prays in me that stirs me. And so his light in us, his Torah, it stirs us or it causes us to be enlightened or the light to shine my way of judgment. Without judgment, our light becomes dim and our countenance becomes dim. We become angry, we become offended, we become distant from one another. Come on, don't look at me, look at your damn selves. I'm not offended at truth. I just wish those that were my leaders had the gall and the unction to teach me like this. And they did not. Hallelujah. I love the way Baruch, the scribe of Jeremiah, puts this in a fashion that is so explainable in the book of 2 Baruch, chapter 19, verse 1, as he speaks on the power of what it profits us to walk in the righteousness of Torah. He speaks in Baruch, 2 Baruch 19:1. And Yah answered me, and he said to me, therefore I have Yah appointed a Brit for them, that at that time, we're in that time, and said, behold, I appoint for you life and death. He set before us life and death, tov and evil. Choose life that we may live. Yahshua is the light or the life of this world.
And he called Hashemayim and the Olam as a witness and aid against them. For he, listen now, Baruch knew. He's talking about Moshe, but the revelation of Yeshua here. For he knew that his time was short. Yeshua knew his time was short. He knew it. We don't understand that our time is short. He knew that his time was short, but that Hashemayim, the heavens and the earth will stay olam. He knew that his duration on the earth, like your time and my time, it is short. But heaven and earth will pass away before the Torah of Yah pass away. And we must understand by the Torah of his wisdom, he created all things. He made nothing to be dissolved. He's going to renew this earth. He's not going to create another one. He's going to renew it. His presence shall illuminate the earth, Yisrael. The old things are going to pass away. And as the earth, as with our case, when the light of Torah shines in us, the old things pass away, become new. It's one thing that the daylight brings. It brings a renewing of one's ruach, doesn't it? Yeshua knew that his time was short, but that the heavens and earth shall stay forever. We, the nations, however, the people, they sin and they trespass after his death. Did they do that after the death of Moshe? Did they do it after the death of Yeshua? Oh, I speak to the witness of that profoundly. I have sinned egregiously, willingly, with disdain for Yah. And they even sin after his death. Although they knew that they had the Torah. For what? To reprove them that light in which none could err. We err because there is no light. We need to awaken unto the light. Light arouses you. It caused the faculties and the functions of your mind and the tentacles of your body to come alive, to be rejuvenated. We have a Torah to reprove us. And we don't give a damn about Yah's reproving. We have a Torah to reprove us. Why? We must be corrected in order for light. In order for the other light in which none could error that will shine from us, that the light of his testimony. Light and darkness cannot dwell in the same bosom, the same mind. Apart from the spears which witness at me, Yah says, and I judge everything that exists. Does the Torah judge everything? Every thought, every action, every deed, every concept. Why? That the power of light, that Yeshua's witness may shine. We must be awakened unto the light. We're going to need light in this dark day. We're going to need light in these darkened days. We are in the Akharith. And we must prepare. And it's one thing that when the light shined, you can prepare. It's difficult to prepare when your mind is darkened. You don't know how to function. You don't know how to move. Everything is erratic. Everything is distorted. I can't even think clearly. You ever said that? Your mind doesn't function properly. So that is the nature of the Torah. To bring judgment. To correct us. For what reason? That the power of Yah's light may illuminate in us that we do not err. We do not walk contrary to the mitzvah, the commands, the instructions, the counsel, the statutes. We do not go beyond the boundaries of what Yah commands us, but we walk in the light of the lighted way. And Yahshua was in the way, and as long as they walked in the way, he kept them in the way. The way is Torah. It is Torah. That is the way, Yisrael. And so here this man that strives in writing from the Loshon, the Nobi, he writes precisely. He was led by the Ruach. He was a Kadosh man. And the writings are necessary for us as well, Yisrael, because our minds are Pharisaic. We think we have the element in all of this technology we can learn and we can research things. It doesn't mean a damn thing. It pollutes us even the more. This is a common man. It's a simple salvation. It is a simple Yoshach. He'll just give me the dictionary because I don't have great understanding of word meaning. You may, but I don't. I don't need the references, the interlinears and all of that. These are damn corrupt men. It's not that they don't have a knowledge of the letter of things and they can write historically. I will take advantage of that. But the spiritual revelation only comes by the light. It only comes by the light. And it's when the Torah judges us and brings us to the awakening. It is the light in us. He's already put it in us. He's already put it in us. Let's bestow that upon us. It simply must be awakened. And the only time it's going to be awakened when we stop our progressive nature of sinning and defying Yah. That's the only way, Yisrael. I like the way Yahshua talked. He speaks here in his discourse with this Pharisaic mindset that think that they have the power to deduct what Torah says in the book of Yahkahana, John 8:12. And he speaks to this Pharisaic mind today, us all. You're part of the us, my friend. You that have joined us on the live you stream. Have we had the masses of the people to fall off? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They're falling off? How many are falling off? Oh, that's all right. Hallelujah. That's all right. There, folks, there was a woman that called me the other day, and she began to tell me about her story. I said, ma'am, I don't want to hear that. How she was an exotic dancer, pole dancer. She has a book out on... the book is at Barnes & Noble. And I said, ma'am, that's not a testimony. I said, you think your sins, even of your whoredom and your corruption, are any different than anyone else's? I said, your sins and your wickedness are no different than one that has never touched a man. No different than a Bethula, a woman that think in herself righteousness because she has never touched a man, or a young man think he has never touched a woman. And they think they are right because that's the only thing that makes them right. That's a damn lie. They've touched every kind of unclean thing. They have sinned wickedly. I said, so your sins and your actions, they are no more different. They have no more content than no one else's sin. You have not done anything that no different than any other man or woman. I said, I don't want to hear that. I said, you're married. She said, yeah. I said, you shouldn't even put your husband under that kind of shame. So why in the hell would you want to bring that up? I'm talking like this. Why would you put a book out there for your children to do? I say, that's what this religious whore has done. She's a whore. She's a damn whore. This religious Christianity, you writing a book about your damn filth? And so people get excited about me when I began to speak to them. I say, lady, don't do your husband like that. I said, these damn wicked men, they call themselves leaders. They want you to talk like that because they want to prowl into your bedroom. You talking like that, that arouses them. I said, I don't want to hear a damn thing. I said, I don't want to know nothing about you. I don't need to. For what? I said, what relevance is that to me? Your sins are no more outstanding than the one that has never had sex, have never gone the way you have gone. No different. For all have sinned. It comes short of the order of God. Sin is sin. I don't give a damn. I don't give a damn what the process is. It's still sin. And for some reason, the world has put a value. Oh, he was a drug addict, so he got a lot to tell. He doesn't have anything to tell. He was a damn dope head. He may have been a dub, hey, but he was a damn rebellious boy. He was full of pride that you taught him, thought he was better. What's the difference? When sin is finished, it brings forth the same thing, death. I said, don't tell me a damn thing. I don't want to hear that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yahshua, as he speaks to us with this corrupt mind, he says to us, Yochanan 8:12. I want to move quickly. All right. Yeah. Yochanan chapter 8, verse 12. He began to speak his Amir, Amir, Amma. Then spoke Yahshua again to them, saying, I am the light of Yah's creation. When Yah says, let there be light, it was the power of the testimony that shall be revealed unto us. He said, I am the light. He that follows me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. He is the Torah. When the Torah proceeds from Yah, light is Torah. He said, I am that light. And when a man follows me, he shall not walk in darkness. What a man is in Yahshua, just like Baruch says, the Torah to reprove them, that light in which nothing could error. Can we error in Yahshua? Can we err out of the way in Yahshua? We cannot. We must be awakened unto the light. And the only way we're going to be awakened, we must be judged, Yisrael. It is the power of Torah that judges us, or bring the Mishpatim of Yah to bring us to the light. He is the light. And if a man walks in Yahshua, he will not walk in sin. He will not walk in darkness. These damn liars, we're sinners. We're sinners saved by this Jezebel grace. Damn grace. It is the no harm of Yah, his tender kindness of his great love. Damn the pagan deities. Damn them. Hallelujah. I don't repent. If I die, let me die. I'm going to die anyway, so let me die here. Hallelujah. He is the light of the world, Yisrael. He prayed, Yah, I know that you can't take them out of the world, but, you know, he can't, and he did not take us out of the world. But he wanted Yah to guide us and to make sure that we were Shema kept in the world. We're not earthly vessels made of the world. Look at what Yahshua says here in chapter 9 of the same book, verse 5. He says, as long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world. We're earthen vessels. And as long as he is in this earthen vessel, he is our light. And there's one thing that light does, it exposes everything. You see things that you never saw. And as long as he is in this world, as long as the Torah is in us, we have light. And when the Torah is not in us, that's why the five foolish had no light. That's why they had no oil, because they were not incited to rise with a great fervor of strength, powerfully, against their own mind that opposed Almighty Yah in Yahshua. So we must be excited when we hear the words. We must be excited. That's why we must enter into his presence with Torah in our bosom, Yisrael. Yeah. Bless Yah for the light. I brought him for the light of this day. Hallelujah. We're no different than those Yisraelites. And those that pursued him, questioned him. It is because of our unbelief we cannot enter into the light. Because we know once we enter in, it's going to expose all the darkness. And those that didn't even believe him, even the Hebrews, those that say that they love Yah, he addressed them for their wickedness and their unbelief here in the same book of the 12th chapter, verse 46. Yochanan 12:46. He says, I have come a light into the Olam Hezel, or into the world, that whosoever believes on me should not abide in darkness. We don't believe the testimony.
I had someone, and I'm going to teach on it. She lives in London, and she takes all of our messages. She has a YouTube channel, and she puts all of our messages on the everything. A young woman, 26, 27 years old, very attractive young woman too, very attractive, very, very attractive. She is. I want her to listen to me more, that she will dress in a way that will please a father, all right? She's a very attractive woman. I mean, very attractive. Very attractive. Not just attractive, but very attractive. But she should dress in a way that is pleasing unto Yah. All right, my bad. You love me. All right. No one knows you but me. And so she writes to me and asks to teach on the virgin birth. Well, I'll do that. We may think we understand that, but we really don't. We don't understand the Beth'ula of the Ulmat of Yah. We think we do. Because we really don't give a damn. Hey, but one thing we study the habitual habits of the God, our bellies. We got a damn dirty God in our bellies, a greedy bastard. It's a greedy spirit. And we love the God of our bellies above all things, our own greed, our own lust. And it defies every commandment of Almighty Yah. Hallelujah. That's all we love. We love me, myself, and I. We don't even love that. Hallelujah. I will come on, my friend. Don't worry. I will bowl. That's right. Enter in. I will bowl. 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 Enter in. Come on. That's right. Hallelujah. Can I move a little farther? All right. I will do that for us. I want to read this account in the book of Melechim, First Melechim. This is Shlomo's vision that Yah gave him. And his prayer, I know, and we remember that Zachin Yerameyah taught to him, Sukkot, without a vision, the people shall perish. They shall lose tikva. They shall not be inspired by the things to come that shall be. And what is prepared for us. So as Shlomo begins to cry out, he prays here in 1 Kings 3:9. The first thing he says, verse 9, chapter 3, verse 9. He says, Yahweh, you not find you give. Therefore to your abet, your servant, the one that delights in obeying you. 1 Kings chapter 3, verse 9. Give unto your servant an understanding or a shemach, understanding left for what? To operate in this fashion. It is one thing the Torah does. It calls the understanding of Yah to be opened up unto us. He wanted an understanding heart that he could shofat. He could judge or govern the people according to Torah. That he could judge them according to Torah. That even the vindication of the actions and deeds will be according to Torah, the punishment, but according to Torah. That is what the Shafat is. He said that I may judge your people, that I may be or discern to have the power and wisdom of understanding to consider the actions and the deeds between that which is tov and evil. We don't know the difference between what is tov and evil. For who is able to judge this your so great a people, a gadol. And the speech that he spoke, it pleased the sovereign Yah. That Shlomo had asked, or he had besought Yah with a pleading of begging, that he had asked this thing, that he had asked for just that. That should be our prayer, to teach me, Yah, to judge between what is tov and evil. What is right and wrong? You take no side. I take no one's side. I take the Torah side. I don't give a damn about our emotions, how you feel toward me. I take the Torah side. Even if you're right, I still will correct you. Because you're going to seek your right. It is Yah that justifies you. It's not your damn actions or your deeds. Cannot go around. Cannot go around. Hell, we don't even know how to receive something when someone is kind to us. Hallelujah. I said to my friend Micaiah, what he was here doing, tabernacle here in his Israel, they had given so much money, he brought me a check. I said, no. And he looked at me, and I had to repent. I said, I'm sorry. It's my juvenileness, his heart, so tender and kind. I said that to him, did I not? Did I not say that? Talk to me, man. And I immediately repented. I said, forgive me, man. That's my wickedness. The man had given so much. I said, no, I'm not taking it. It was wicked of me. It was wicked of me. That's right, it was wicked. And I saw his heart torn when I said that. He just looks at me. And I said, my friend, my heart welled up with weeping. I said, I'm so sorry. Forgive me. I'm wrong. Hell, we don't even know how to say we're wrong. I was wrong. That was not his action. Y'all said he will cause men to give to our share, to our bosom. He will cause one another to give unto your bosom. I've always had problems with that. I remember the first gift that my Isha Ima gave me. I said, take it back. I didn't know how to receive a gift because I've never had gifts given to me, and I didn't know how to accept it. I said, take it back. I don't want it. I didn't know how to reciprocate that. I didn't. I was young and stupid. My Ima, I was stupid. 22, 23 years old. Didn't know a damn thing. But I didn't know how to tell her things. So I said, take it back. And then as the day progressed, I began to feel ashamed. And I wore that shirt and kept it for many, many years because she gave it to me. That was the first time anyone had given me a gift. Anyone. First time. I'm not talking about that damn mess toys for Christmas. First time someone had given me a gift. And my heart was overwhelmed. My friend Micaiah, it was a long time before I would take an offering from someone. I was scared, first of all. And I'm glad y'all trained me that way. I was scared. Because I did not want to take advantage and abuse it, because I knew that there was trouble at the end. We must awaken. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Verse 11, and you all said to him, because you have asked this thing, and have not asked for yourself long life, neither have you asked riches for yourself, nor have you asked life for your enemies, but you have asked for yourself being discernment, wisdom of understanding, to discern judgment. Y'all give us all that. The understanding to discern judgment. And when your Torah speaks to us, it calls us to be awakened. When the Torah speaks to us, it calls us to be awakened. We're not dead. We come alive and we rejoice. You understand? You said, and I have also given you that which you have not asked, both riches and splendor, so that there should not be any among the melechim, the kings, the rulers, lack to you all your days of your life. He prefers that unto Shlomo. He said, and if you walk in my way, my derech, you halach, you strive, you persist, you traverse, in the Torah, am I direct? What is this way? He says to Shema, to keep my hook, the ordinance of my limitations, what I have prescribed to you, what is duly due unto me. You walk in my hook, he said, and in my mitzvah, as your avat Dawid did, he said, then, only then will I lengthen your days if we walk in the Torah of delight. He will lengthen our days. And it says this, An Shlomo he yachatz. He awoken. He was awakened. He became active. He began to rejoice. His heart was made fat. Then he became active. He became, there was a generation of life in him. According to the promises of the revelation of Yeshua HaMashiach, he yachatz. And it said, and behold, it was a halum, a dream. It was a prophetic revelation. And he came to Yerushalayim, and he stood before the ark of the testimony, the berith of Yah. And he offered up burnt offerings, and he offered shalom offerings, and he made a feast for all of his servants. When Yah opens, when he yachatz our eyes, you got to offer up the offering of Torah. The reason we don't, because our eyes are not open. We are still dead and trespassing in our sin. When he says, let everything have breath, we mean, don't do it. To praise him, to have joy. And we don't do it. We're still in our sins. Every word is pure. I don't give a damn what your inward parts speak. It is what is spoken out of the volume of our Lashon. And we must speak it to his pleasure. He began to offer up this great offer. That's what we must do. When our eyes, when there has been an awakening, when there has been a yachatz, when we have been stirred and inspired by Torah's revelation, we must make the offering of praises and Torah unto Yah Yisrayah, that we rejoice with great delight in the abundance of his knowledge, because he gives us riches. And not only that, long of days and length of days. I want to live. I'm living to live. I want to live. I don't want to die. I'm not ready to die. He may take me now, but I want to live, Yisrayah. I'm living to live. He that will love life and see better days, let him reframe his faith from evil. Let there be no guile, no wickedness found in him. Hallelujah. I love life. I want to live, Yisrayah. And Yah, according to Torah, he has given me the prescribed prescription to live. Because he lives, I can live. I can live. I can face the circumstances of tomorrow. I want to live. I don't want to die. Hallelujah. I want to see him even when he comes. We have that same inspiration. I don't care if you're getting old. We're going to live. We're going to walk on the streets of New Yerushalayim. We're going to walk hand in hand with Yeshua on the streets of Yerushalayim. I want to walk that way. Yes, I do. I want on his shoes then. I want on the garment of Sadiq. Hallelujah. That's why we need the Torah to open up his mishpat, that we may have light in us, Yisrayah. Hallelujah. Here's a writing out of the book of Hanach. I have a few more verses I want to read to give us some inspiration even in all of the midst of this. But Hanach, the Nobi, he saw things Ram-like. I would say no other Nobi except Yeshua. He was more than a prophet, Yeshua was. He was more than a shulishach. He is the Torah of Yah, where he imparted that into his messengers. But here's a book that Hanach wrote. And the writing of this book, it is the fifth book of Hanach. It is to the offsprings of the earth. Hanach chapter 92 and verse 1. It tells us, book 5. It says, which is written by Hanach Enoch, the writer. I love this when I read this my first time the other day, reading this. He is the writer of Kol All the Uth. Yah never does anything without a sign. That's why these damn hypocrites trying to discern the Mo'adim of Yah, he does nothing without an Uth. It is a distinguished mark. It is a sign. It is a reference.
And so here's a Nobi that is a writer of all signs of wisdom among all the people. He is blessed and known in all the earth. It is written for all the offsprings that dwell upon the earth and for the latter or the Akarif door, the latter generation. We are in the Akarif, we are the last generation. And for the latter generations which uphold Shadiq, righteousness, and Shalom, we must uphold that. We've upheld our sin, our wickedness, but we must uphold the Sadiq Ayah and His Shalom. In the midst of all of this depravity and chaotic mess, we still have His Shalom, His peace, or His comforting, that we are at rest. We have tranquility. I do. When I'm broke, when I feel as though that there is no tomorrow, I still have that. Hallelujah. First of all, I don't allow myself to get that way. That's just me. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to allow the world to rob me of the essence of Yah. I'm not in despair. I got someone to lay my hand. I look around that shack of my eyes, but tears come to my eyes. Yeah, I want to lay my hand. I was telling Akhmikaya, I said, you know, my Isha, she says to me, we got so much stuff here in this cooler. And I said, I can't stop doing what I do because I want to make sure nothing else, we don't go hungry. Because I know what it is to go like. I know what it is to go without. I know what it is to go to school barefooted and to feel the humiliation and the shame of that. I know what it's like to do that. I've gone to school barefoot, and all the children, come on, they were not as cruel then as they are today, but they will mock you. And they did. I was so ashamed. And so I would pretend I was sick, so I would not have to go outside. And so my cousin would give me his socks. I would put them on, and I would wear them. And I said, even then, I would cry and said, quote, God, when I get all of them, mommy's in shoes. I don't know, I have this, I guess, this phobic. I said to him, I have 35 pair of shoes. What a shame. I said, I have that many, probably more, 40. It's the truth. I said, God, if you ever grants to me to buy me some shoes, I will never go barefooted. I've had that many times over shoes. If I didn't even have slacks and suits, I've had shoes. Because it was one of the most humiliating, debilitating things that one could endure in that day. Barefooted. I couldn't understand why my aunts and my grandmother made sure that my cousin, and they had shoes. My mother was not living with us at that time. She was in Delaware. And so she wasn't there. And I didn't have shoes. Well, no one was that concerned. And I'm not talking about in the summertime. I'm talking about when it was cool, too. I lie to you not. I'm not trying to lift me up. Damn you, man. It's just the truth. So when he put on the shoes that were prepared by the forerunners, Moshe and the prophets, then he shod my feet and prepared them to declare the Bizurach of Yahshua. I don't need one pair of shoes. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. My feet are clothed, they're shod. They have been prepared by the mouth of Yahshua. HaMashiach, that's all right. Hallelujah. Yeah. Oh, that doesn't make me weak because of that. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yeah. Oh, he says in verse 2, let your Ruach be troubled by the times. For Yah and the Kodesh and the Great One has designated specific days for all things. Yah has ordained all things for its day, its time. There's nothing done out of the time of Yah. There is nothing that precedes the time of Yah. Yah is the one that designates and put designations on every day in our lives and every nation and every people. It says the Sadiq, the righteous. He's talking about Yisrael here. Yahshua, the righteous one. I like that. We are the Sadiq of Yah. We look like a pile of hog dung. Listen to what Hosea says. He says, the righteous one shall awaken from his sleep. He's going to cause us to awaken from our drunkenness, our yoshin, our sleep. He shall awaken from his sleep. He shall arise, Yachatz. He shall be stirred. He shall rise and walk in the way. He's going to walk in the ways of the Sadiq, of the righteousness, and all the ways of his conduct shall be in Tava and generosity forever. Should not that be the way if we walk in the way when we awaken? We should walk in the way of doing excellent unto each other and generosity. Be kind, take that piece of bread and give it to your neighbor. Give it to your friend. Take that slither of rags and give it to your brother. Give it to your Achyor Holtz. We've been taught to be selfish and wicked as hell. Can't go around this. It's one thing when I lay out scripture. I really don't read them. I read them, but I don't read them. I say, all right, that sounds well. I put that there. Just put it there, paste it. But I don't practice the things in my mind, how it will come forth. See, Yah knows what we need. He begins with his mishpat. Will you direct that to me? Well, sure I am. Are we not the righteous of Yah? Does he not want us to awaken and to rise, to be stirred? Come on. I watch the rebellious one reject that. And where are they now? They are in the way of darkness. He's going to bring a Sadiq in the way, in the way, in the way, the way. Never forget that. It says he will be generous to the Sadiq one, the righteous. He's going to be generous. He's been kind to us. And give him eternal uprightness. He will give authority and judgment and kindness and righteousness. And they, now we know that it is not him or one, they, we, Yisrael, they shall walk in eternal light. Yahshua is the Olam V'ev, the light, the eternal light of Almighty Yah. He's the revelation of Torah that we can walk in that eternal light. His word shall never fade. It shall never fail. His word never fails, Yisrael. It never fails. It's an eternal. When Yah speaks it, it is eternal. It is established. It is me. It is that. It can never be dissolved. We as the nation, we are the righteous, which shall walk in the eternal light. Yahshua. We walk in him. We abide him. We live. We move. We have our being in the light of the Torah of Yahshua. Does this make sense? It does to me. Sin and darkness shall perish. If we sin willfully, it's because we're not walking in the light. Sin shall perish. Sin and darkness shall perish forever. And shall no more be seen from the day evermore. That we as a nation, we should not practice the sin and to walk in sin. Once the light, the eternal light of Yah began to shine on us, sin should not have a form that we will practice it and to carry out the mandate that transgress the Torah of Yah, because we walk in the eternal revelation of the testimony of Yah. Yahshua is that eternal light. Are we going to say damn lies? It is Hashatan that sinned, lied from the beginning because there was no Torah in him. We have the witness, we have the true witness of Torah. Hallelujah. We just must awaken. He's trying to stir us up by judgment to awaken us and bring us back into remembrance. Hallelujah. 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 We are the light. Zochim, better means favorite verse, isn't it? We are the light of the world. Yisrayah. You are the light. That's what Yahshua said, you are the light of the world. How are we the light? Because of the Torah. You want me to read that? Let me find it. I'll read it for you. Here it is right here. Matithiah 5. 14. Does it say here? He says in verse 13. No, he tells verse 12 quickly. Matithiah 5, 13, 12. He says, rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in Hashemayim. For so persecuted they the Nabi, which were before you. He says, you are the salt of the earth. But if the salt lose its fragrance, wherewith shall it be salted? It has no taste. It is therefore taught for nothing. But be cast out and to be trodden on the foot of men. That's all it's worth. And he says to us, Yisrael, you are the light of the world. That's what Baruch said, because we are the Torah of light. We are the light of the world. We are the light of the world. A city that is set upon a hill that cannot be hid. We are the light of the world. 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 Damn what Michael Jackson says. We are the world. You know the song he sang? And all those hypocrites and corrupt pedophiles and liars. We are the people. We are to make a better place. So let's start living. We have no life outside of Yeshua. We are the light of the world. We are the light of the world. We are the beacon of Yah. Yeshua is the light. It is that testimony that lights. He said, while I'm in the world, I'm the light of the world. It's greater is he that is in me than he is in the world. What's in us? Our own damn wickedness, our sin, or is it the power of the testimony of Yeshua? While I am in the world, I'm in the world. I'm the light of the world. Is he in us? Is Yeshua in you? Then we are the light of the world. Come on, mama, clap your hands. That's right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are the light of the world. A city that sits upon the hill and cannot be hidden. I want to close here with a few readings, especially this one out of the book of Baruch, second Baruch. This is the pair, this is a tefillah or a pala of Baruch, the son of Neriah, for Yisrael unto the Abba. He begins this prayer of this resorts of this nature, Baruch, second Baruch 25:1. It says, and Yah answered and said to me, you also will be Nasa. Listen, he said, I'm going to preserve you. You're going to be delivered. I'm going to rescue until that time. He's going to preserve us until that time. Namely, until that sign which Yah, the Most High, will bring about before the inhabitants of the earth at the end days. There shall be no sign given that of the sign of the Nobi Yonah, as he was in the belly of the whale 3 days and three nights, the fish, so shall the son of Yisrael, a man, be in the belly of the earth. So we are the sign until that time for that great sign that has been carried out. Hear me, Yisrael. This then will be the sign, the oath. This will be the distinguished mark that he will give. When horror or amay, when the heart of man fails him, when the dread of distress overtakes him, it says, seize the inhabitants of the earth. They shall fall into many tribulations, to czars, into straits, into fixes, whereby there is no way out. And further, they shall fall into great torment. And it will happen that they will say, this is what they will say as we, in their thoughts, because of the great tribulation, Yahweh, the mighty one, does not anymore remember the earth. Listen, it will happen when they lose tikvah. In the midst of our trials, you say, Yah doesn't care. He said, it will happen when they lose hope, the tikvah. But for us, Yisrael, that the time will awaken. He said, even though that we as a people and those that shall be in great straits, we're going to be in great tribulations, trials like never before. And the reason we will say Yah's forgotten us, because we have lost tikvah. We have lost an insight on the promises of Yah. And only until we are yachatz, we are awakened, will we see the purpose of this oath or the sign that Yah said would be. There will be distress of nation, with perplexities, there will be agony throughout the nations. And because we see this and it has its effects on us, we will lose our take for our hope. We'll say, where is it? He promised he would come, and where is it? Oh, yeah, you will cry like that one, yeah. Only when we are awakened will we be able to discern that this is the hand of Yah Yisrael, that our tikvah may be revived. And the Dabar, the promises of Almighty Yah. That's why he has sent
Yeshua, that we may have true communion with him, YisraYah. And once we have communion with Yeshua, we will walk in the light. A few verses here in the book of 1 Yakahan, and the writing of this letter unto Geisha and the elect. 1 John chapter 1, verse 5. This is the message, the Bezorach, which we have heard of Almighty Yah, and declared unto you that Yahweh is light. He is light. Did not Yahshua come from the bosom of the Abba? Is he not the word of Yah? Yah is light, and in him is no darkness at all. You're not going to find it. In him is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship or communion with him and walk in darkness, we lie. We do not walk in the Torah. See, we must walk in the Torah, Yisrael. These are damn beasts that are telling people that the Torah is not of significance. They're damn liars. They're dogs. They're ignorant dogs. They are the bastard slip. They're not the sons of Yah. But if we walk in the light, as he is the light, if we walk in Yahshua, if we walk in Torah, Yah is light, because Yahshua is the light of Yah, we have fellowship one with another. Not only do we have fellowship among ourselves, but the house of Yisra'iyah, Yehuda and Yisra'iyah have fellowship with each other. And the dumb of Yahshua HaMashiach, the Son, cleanse us from all our sins. And that's the truth. It cleanses us. If we walk in the light, we must be yachatz. I want to close with these three last readings here. And especially at the book of Baruch, first Baruch. I like this. First Baruch, chapter 4, verse 1. This is the book of mitzvah, of the commandments of Yah, and the Torah that endures forever. His Torah is not temporary. It is olam v'at, forever. All they that keep it shall come to life, to the knowledge of Yahshua. I will show you that in my closing. They shall come to life. But such as leave it, they shall die. He tells us to shub, turn you, O Jacob, the house of Yisra'iyah. Take hold of the Torah. Walk in the presence of the light thereof, that you may be illuminated. When we walk in the presence of the Torah, we are illuminated. We are the light of the world. A city that sits upon the hill. We are a damn drunk city. Drunkenness and raging and every kind of unclean spirit is there in our minds and our actions, our activities. Come on, talk to me, Yisra'iyah. Hell, we're well at pretending. I like that. You all like that? I like that, what he says. Turn you at Yah's reproof, O Yaakov, and take hold of it, the Torah of Yah. Walk in the presence of the light thereof, that you may be illuminated. When something is illuminated, it shines. We are the light, a city that sit upon a hill that cannot be hid. Come on, the Siddiq, the power of Yah cannot be hid if we walk in the Torah. We're not walking in the Torah. That's why when strangers see us, they don't perceive that there's something about that one, that individual, that is different. We are light unto all the nations. We are the light unto all the nations. We are the ones that they should bring the commerce and the riches into, Yisra'iyah. Because we walk in darkness, there is none coming there. Well, how is that so? Well, this is what Yahshua says. Am I closing here in the book of Yakahan, John chapter 8? Again, I want to read this. I'm sorry. Yakahan chapter 6, verse 63. I want to close from here. Yahshua said, it is the Ruach that quickens or make alive. The flesh profits nothing. Yahshua said, the words that I speak to you, they are Ruach and they are life. The Torah has the power of Yah's Ruach, his hide, his living substance. His DNA is in the Torah. And it calls us to have the chayin, the strength to live and to overcome the opposition. That's why you say, I'm not going to die. I'm going to live because in Yahshua HaMashiach, I can do all things and I hide nothing. That's why we must walk in the light of your Torah. Agam Yisrayah, Yachatz, awaken out of our drunkenness. Yabrach, we do pray that Yah has strengthened the bosom of Yisrayah. He caused us to rejoice with great delight. May Yabrach you, let us stand to our feet. Almighty Yan Yahshua's name, we do barak you this Shabbat. What a great day you have granted unto us. We have life, we have strength, and we have health. Even though in the midst of our agony, of our pains, we do barak you for all things. We ask you to touch Kol Yisrayah Mishpeha, guide us and strengthen us all. Teach us and direct us. As an ummah, a community of a nation of people, touch us all, heal us. We need that. We need each other. I need Yisrayah. I don't want to be by myself. I don't want to be a man, as the old song, no man is an island, no man stands alone. I don't want to stand alone. I want to stand with your people. Behold how tough and how pleasant it is for the Ach to dwell together. I want to dwell with Yisrayah. Touch us all and guide us, strengthen us all in the blessed assurance of the only name given unto us to be Yahshua, the name of Yahshua HaMashiach. And as the old one said, until we gather in this place again, we shall barak you. And with our voices, we cry, hallelujah. 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 Yabarak Yisrayah. May His shalom rest upon you.